It's Amanda, and I want to come to you briefly on a topic, and that topic on today is others may have underestimated you, but God will prepare a table. I don't know what you may be going through on today, my friend, but I'm here to let you know, without being arrogant and high-minded, that it is okay for you to succeed. In fact, God said he wants your light to so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. God is a God of restitution. God is a God who's concerned about your success. Hallelujah. It's so good news to hear that thing today. Understand and believe that the eye of the Lord is in every place. Know this. Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Now, I only have a few short minutes to be with you on today. Hallelujah. But I want to encourage that one who may be going through a time. This message is not for everybody, but this message is definitely for somebody. My friend, don't allow people to talk greasy over your situation, over your future. And this is not a message designed to bring condemnation or division. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. This is not a message that is designed to bring division and confusion. In fact, God is not the author of confusion. He commands the blessing where there's unity. In Amos 3, he states, how can two walk together unless they be in agreement? So I want to quickly hit three bullet points that I'm just coming up with off the top of my head right now. Hallelujah, that will help to catapult you into your future, into your assignment. Number one, hallelujah, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all of these things to be added. That comes out of Matthew 6:33. That's the number one thing to understand, that God is our source. Hallelujah. You'll be disappointed if you put your trust in man too much. In Jeremiah 17:7, it states, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope the Lord is. Hallelujah. If you're looking for a man to bail you out, hallelujah. If you're looking for a personality or an individual to accept you, he shut up a kuta, you may be let down, my friend. Hallelujah. This is the reality of the situation. So we said the first tactic is to seek first the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Give him the first fruits of your praise, of your time. Hallelujah. Of your supplication. Number two, stay in prayer. Hallelujah. In 1 Thessalonians 5, it states, rejoice forevermore, pray without ceasing, and everything to give thanks. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Man may have counted you out. Hallelujah. Man may have underestimated you. He shot up a sita, but they don't know all there is to know about you. Hallelujah. It says in Psalms 91, God has given his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. They shall bear you up in their hands lest you dash your foot against a stone. Think about it this way. Hallelujah. Folks you grew up with, people in your family, aunties, uncles, hallelujah, teachers, they know who you are, neighbors. Oh, that's such and such child. You know, this is twofold. Hallelujah. Oh, no, they ain't like that. You know, they know you. Hallelujah. To some aspect of respect. He shout up a kuyata. And then a stranger, no name stranger on your job. Hallelujah. Oh, they just the most nasty. Some folks like the gossip. Hallelujah. So they would try to paint, hallelujah, an inaccurate picture of you. He shout about see it to fit what their stereotype is. In their own head, they're having a drama. Hallelujah. Don't allow people to try to paint you as something you're not. Because if you're not careful, you may find those characteristics trying to creep up on you. Hallelujah. We cast down every demonic, hallelujah, spirit that have been demonically assigned. You ever notice, hallelujah, even folks speaking over children, oh, they just bad. Who shout about it? You know, you don't want to start speaking those kind of things over people, hallelujah, because those spirits may try to come to find them. Man may have underestimated you, but God wants to prepare a table, hallelujah, for your destiny. Well, what do you think changed when you became grown, when you became an adult? He shout about Citorosia. Folks want to say stuff about you, hallelujah, that's not lining up with God's word. He takes us from faith to faith and from glory to glory. Hallelujah. You can actually call things that be not as though they were. Don't get too comfortable, hallelujah, letting people downplay, hallelujah, the anointing that's on your life. And James 4:10, it states, humble yourself in the sight of the Lord and he'll lift you up. Yes, we're called to humility, but he also tells us in another reference of scripture, cast not away your confidence, for it has a great recompense of reward. Hallelujah. Don't let that devil, hallelujah, dictate what your future is or what's not going to be. He shut up. I see him on top. That's why it says give no place to the devil. Hallelujah. We have emotions here. It says be angry and sin not. He tells us a merry heart doeth good like a medicine. You need to gain control and mastery over your thoughts. Hallelujah. And that's going to be my third point. Hallelujah. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. It's extremely important to condition our emotions and our mindset, hallelujah, in alignment with God. Does this sound like it's a hard thing? Hallelujah, it really isn't. He shut up a seat to anything you become consistent in, you can become proficient in. Understand that God is calling you, hallelujah, to that higher place of glory. He shut up a seat, order of a seat to those here. So we want to seek God first, hallelujah, praise God. He should have a seat to. We want to pray without ceasing. He should have a seat to. And we want to kind of get our minds right. That is part of the process of knowing that God is preparing that table. Now, when you get some time, go into Psalm 23. Hallelujah. Because that's what I'm basing it off of. You got to know that God is your source. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He's going to lead you in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Hallelujah. We may have ups, we may have downs and adversity, but God is not calling us to become losers. He shout about, oh, Rabba, Sirokuya, Mansabra. We are blessed to be a blessing. Who can you help? Hallelujah. He shout about, see, if you're struggling yourself, understand that part of this is things that were imposed upon you demonically that you got to learn how to break and cast down. Hallelujah. Shout about, see, Autumn receive. See that over my life. Ooh, shut up, I see it. God's called me to be the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. And we don't want to just have a passion and a zeal for God, but to have understanding. And that's why it says wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. But in all you're getting, get understanding. Know that you don't have to believe the lies of the enemy. God wants to fight your battles. He shut up a seat to Rosia. He wants to war on your behalf. Hallelujah. But you've got to have this in your mind, an understanding that God wants you to win. He wants you to succeed. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. I want to add a fourth point in. Know who you are in Christ. Hallelujah. Understand that you may have done some things in your past, my friend. I've done some things in my past. But this is not going to be limiting what God wants to do in your future. No man having put their hands to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom. Man may have underestimated you, but God is going to prepare a table. It says he'll use the foolish things of this world to confound the wise, the base things. He shut up, I see you. Go in there and walk for your promise, my friend. He shut up, I see you. I don't care how many days you've been failing. Hallelujah. This can be the day that you win. He shut up a seat. Did you wake up this morning? Did God start you on your way? Hallelujah. In everything, give thanks. There's always at least one thing, hallelujah, that we can praise God for. And I'm not here to preach at you because there are folks who are hurting. He shut up a seat. They want answers. They want to know why is all this stuff happening? Hallelujah. Stop putting the devil, hallelujah, in a driver's seat in your life. Hallelujah. You've got to learn to take authority over that thing. Hallelujah. It's important to assemble. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm telling you, one could put 1,000 to flight, two could put 10,000 to flight. God is calling you to success. God is calling you to favor. Hallelujah. It says that a man's gift will make room for him and prepare him and bring him in the presence of mighty men. Hallelujah. I'm paraphrasing. God will show you favor. Hallelujah. You may get a phone call. Who shut up? I see it out. You may be introduced to somebody in a high place. Hallelujah. Now, we don't idolize anyone. He should have received it, but it says to give honor to where honor is due. Understand that there is a rank in the spirit realm. Hallelujah. But God is no respecter of person. He shut up a seat. He tells us, don't think more highly of yourself than you ought to. Understand that God can do it for anybody, so God can do it for you. Well, until next time, my friend, hallelujah, understand that man may underestimate you. He shut up a seat. But God will prepare that table. It says promotion don't come from the east, west, or the south. Promotion comes from the Lord. He's the God that set up one and put another down. He shut up, I see ya. Don't ever get too comfortable because God can turn the tables just like that. He shut up, akuyata, mantabra. But and we know all things work together for good to them who love the Lord, who are called according to his purpose. Shalom.